In this video, we'll show you how to use SimCenter TestLab Neo to calculate principal strains and stresses as well as critical planes from a rosette strain gauge. Here I have my rosette strain gauge recording. It's got three channels at specific angles, which I'm displaying below. To do the processing, I want to go to File here, and I'm going to turn on Process Designer under Add-ins. Load data analysis and interactive analysis. After having done that, I can go over to the method library, and if I go all the way down, there's some combined methods, including rosette calculations for a 0, 45, 90 degree gauge. And I'll take the strain gauge from my project and I will put it in the input basket. And then I'll connect the input basket to this process. By the way, I could also go under this PC and I could also grab a rosette strain gauge recording from any directory on my PC and put it into the input basket for processing. I've got the rosette. Notice I've got some parameters to set here. For example, I can see that it's looking for the 0 degree channel to be identified. I can do this one of two ways. I can come up here and select over here channel ID. And you can see we have the 0 degree data on channel C1, 45 degree data on channel 2, and 90 degree data on channel 3. So I can update this to reflect that. If I didn't want to use channel IDs, I could leave this field blank, and based on the DOF ID, for example, there it has 90 degrees in it, I could use some wild characters like this, 90, and that would assign that data to that channel, just a different way of doing it. You only need to do one of these methods per channel. With everything identified, I can go ahead and hit run to do my calculations. If the calculation doesn't work for you, by the way, if you go to Process here, Include for Processing, you might want to check that there's not some restrictions on that are preventing the data from being processed. I'll hit Cancel there. I've done the calculations. Before I accept it, I can click on Active Analysis and I can view all the results. So here are the three original signals. But I've also managed to calculate the principal strain, the angle of the principal strain, and I also have things like the principal stresses, etc. If I'd like to calculate the critical planes, so see the strain gauge history at 0, 10 degrees, 20 degrees, 30 degrees, etc., until I get to 70 degrees, I can grab this critical plane method. And I might be interested in which plane has the most damage. So I could also grab some other methods here, like rainflow counting, for example. Connect that up. Calculate some range pairs from that. And then based on some material curves, which are set over here, calculate some damage. Here too, I'm going to set what the channels are. So channel 1, channel 2, channel 3. I will turn this method off. I'll hit reject here. I'll hit run here to do the calculations. And I can start to look at the time histories at any one of the degree orientations. Here I'm getting all the information for this, so I'll go under Home, and I'll switch this to DOF ID versus function. And so, for example, I could look at the individual time histories. And maybe for those time histories, I want to see which one of these three directions had the most damage. In this case, I can see it was at angle 0, had a lot more damage than angle 10 and angle 20. and I could view all the data till I determine the most critical plane and its degree direction. By the way, these methods only work on one rosette gauge at a time. So if you need to do more than one rosette, because you collected more than one in your acquisition, you would have to define another critical plane or another rosette method. And you could use things like the split or the pass option. To send individual rosettes into the methods as needed. Thank you.